Hi, I'm Phil Buckman. I'm the bass player in the band Filter and bass player in the band Petty Cash. And we are here in Hamburg, Germany. We are at the beginning of our European leg of our tour that we're going to be on for the rest of time, it seems. There's drums. And that's it. I'm here to talk to you today about Kemper Profiling Amplifiers. The thing sounds amazing. I literally got it right before I left a few months ago to go on tour, so I haven't had the opportunity to get fully into it. But just out of the box, plugging it in, and plugging it through the speakers in my stereo, it sounds amazing. The tones are incredible for both guitar and bass. I mean, I play both through it, and just messing around with the different effects that are built in without actually really diving into it, just out of the box. It's amazing. I mean, when I met you at the NAMM show, I told you the same thing, just plugging it in at the display. I played like three notes and I was like, I'm sold. This thing sounds better than any other modeler. I know it's not a modeler, it's a profiler, but it could be compared, product-wise, it's comparable to an amp modeler or an amp modeling software. And it sounds way better, way more authentic than anything I've ever heard. And I'm using Harkey amps right now, and one amp, the one that goes direct, is my clean channel, and that's basically all the treble is out, all the mid range is out. It's just low end, so it's very subby, it's very low end, and that powers 15 inch speakers. And then the other, out off the splitter, the other channel goes through my pedals, and I'm using Zoom pedals, V3 pedals, two of those, and Dunlop bass wah. I use the Zoom for the distortion, for chorus, for delay, for some volume swell, bowed bass sort of sound, and that goes into the amp with a lot of the low end taken out, and then just all the high frequencies. This way, whenever I hit my distortion, I don't lose my low end, which is a problem that a lot of bass players have when they hit distortion. I haven't gotten to fully, dive in and profile my amps that I'm using, but the stuff that was in there sounded great. It sounded, there was some Ampeggy kind of things, and they just sound true. They sound true, and it sounded as if it was mic'd in another room, and it was just going direct. So there's no chance to lose any of your sound. Yeah, bringing your own gear is tough. I mean, we're on this European tour, and I mean, Harkey has sent me, because I'm one of their artists, they've sent me a rig to use on this tour. It's not the same rig that I use at home. They don't have the amp that I personally use or the cabinets, so they sent me another series of amp, and wow, somebody doesn't want to fall in love really badly. We maybe want to tell them that we're trying to do an interview. So it's not exactly the models that I use, which it's fine, it's getting by, but it's not what I would prefer. With the Kemper, when I go back and I can redo everything, I'll be able to model my amps, profile my personal amps, and in what's it, 3-space rack. So in a 6-space rack case, I can bring my entire rig with me. Plus, I can do things that I can't do with my current rig, like for a distortion channel, I may just bypass a bass amp altogether and do like a Marshall half stack and get that true sort of distortion sound, rather than just worrying about a pedal and actually have a full amplifier giving me that sound. You just have so many more options with no more equipment. So it's a beautiful thing.